smell us.
Yeah.
This one goes out to my badger out there.
Mind camera?
No.
Well, yes, so. Oh, yes.
Maybe? No. What's the back of your head? All right.
Smell my dick. You can taste it, too, if you want when you're down there.
And if you like to smell dick, call in at 909-475-7449. Yeah, at some point of the show, because we just have a lot of questions to ask.
Yeah.
Badger, call in. I know you smell dick.
You know it's going to be Badger could be calling in because she's a fucking whore, and she likes to smell dick. It's really fucking serious.
Smell these nuts.
Dude, this is going to be an interesting show.
It is. We're back.
Just for everything.
Because they're looting in that part of Compton.
They are. Because we have the British invaded the studios today. We have underdog cops. Ooh, undercops. Undercocks?
Yeah.
Finish him.
Dude, that's just fucking, dude. God damn it.
It's the real pigs radio.
Fucking undercocks. God damn. You know what? Just for the underdog, because he has an undercock.
People, let me tell you about my best friend. She's a warm-hearted person who loves me till the end.
You're listening to Pigs Radio, broadcasting live from a secret location in Compton, California. The talk show that makes psychiatrists see other psychiatrists.
Other psychiatrists. Pigs Radio episode 201. We survived 200 episodes. We're back with 201. This episode still features no Badger. She's out there being a whore.
This fucking... Hoary Badger.
Is she back to her hoary ways?
Allegedly not, but dude, it makes no other sense why.
I honestly think she wants the D, dude. I think she's coming back around. I honestly do.
Like deep dicks for sadness?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. That's it. She's not calling in.
Too soon?
She's back in the closet. She's back in the fucking Badger cave.
Well, I don't know. I don't really play this for her, but she's not here. So. But there are none.
There's some badgers in this house. But yeah, there's absolutely no badgers in this house. There's some whores in
this house. There's some whores. You know, just for shits and giggles, we'll chant her name anyway. She's a whore. She's not here, but let's get her for the very whorish
badger.
Badger. Badger. Badger. Badger. Suck a dick, fucking whore.
Smell my dick.
I almost dropped the board.
I'll drop the board.
All right. So apparently we have an actual story from the one and only. From the underdog himself.
What's up, you motherfucker?
Wow, that's a lot of energy.
It's like this guy's all fucking. He's in cop mode.
It's motherfucker.
Get it right, will ya?
Fucker.
So
fuck off, right?
He's got his utility belt on. Thank you.
So the underdog hasn't been here for, I don't know, it's been a few months. And have you noticed?
5 months. Dude.
5 months.
That's how long it's been. 5 months.
That's badger mouth.
Have we determined how much K5 is? Or
it's a lot.
It's an infinite number. You know what I mean? I just don't know.
It's like infinity times infinity.
It's spelled like KA5. You know what
times
I mean?
K5, and then you get 2 K5.
Damn.
Square root of K5.
But so underdog is back. And by the way, have you noticed that he's always here the days that Badger's not here?
Yeah, what's up with that?
Maybe we're the same person.
I think he's trying to say.
Drop child, fool. I want to see you got fucking red pubic hair.
How do you know it's red?
Oh, well, I'm assuming,
the
right?
Carpet matches the drapes, huh?
I don't know.
Superwoman.
Now, underdog, is there a reason for this pattern of when she's here, you're not, and then when you're here, she's not?
It's visitation
rights.
What's going
on? Oh, like
this
a
is my weekend.
Couple.
This is my weekend.
This is your weekend with the kids.
So you guys broke up.
Your weekend with the pigs. There you go.
So wait a minute. So since he goes to Disneyland, he's gonna be a cop. Are you gonna be an undercover cop at Disneyland?
I might.
Ooh. That's probably what he's really talking about when he says he's kind of like a Disneyland cop.
Like mock
cops. You're so fucking gay, dude. Are you gonna be one of those cops with all the fucking gay ass badges on their fucking jackets and shit?
Yeah, probably.
So let me ask you, dude. Yeah. Where did all this come from? The wanting to be a cop, dude. I mean, you're how old are you now?
I'm 30.
gonna be 31.
So at the age of 30, all of a sudden you're just like, I want to be a cop.
You know what? It's something I've always wanted to do, and I'm kind of at a crossroads on what to do with the rest of my fucking life. So
for the people out in Pigs Radio Land, let me make you understand the underdog. The underdog likes to get up around 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right.
Okay.
You could do graveyard shift.
That sounds good. That sounds good. And actually, that's a good start.
And if he could sleep even more and not do anything else, that would be his job. He is the human version of a sloth.
He smells like one.
He's hairy like one. But sometimes he does get the algae stuff in the back.
Right.
And he just
like all the moss.
Dude, yeah, just. But that's the underdog.
Nobody grows around my dick, but.
Aww.
Just kidding. Just kidding, all the females out there.
So that's the underdog, and you want to become a cop. So you thinking about a year that's going to happen?
Ah, oh, shit.
What happened?
Mario, you're fucking up already.
I didn't do shit. I think he just blew up his own mic.
No undersloth.
Undersloth.
Hello?
See? Fucking up.
A cop.
I may or may have not participated in drugs. So
what?
No more smoke weed.
So I think if I'm at least a year clean when I apply, then I might have a better chance.
We're under the assumption that whatever drugs you took,
they're just
quote
gonna
unquote,
look at Pigs Radio, they're not gonna hire you. You
know, dude. Like,
yeah. No, he's fucking racist.
By the way, they're gonna hear
misogynist.
Your
misogynist.
They're gonna hear your rap battles
drunkness.
And not want to fucking make you join the fucking
this
police.
Fool can't hear rap. How's he gonna patrol fucking South Central? He can't rap.
Fool, you ain't no Denzel. Shit.
Say no Training Day, son.
But yeah, and I'm also fat, so I gotta get in shape before I do all that shit.
You're at least
shut
like
up, skinny.
You're at least what? Like what? What are you pushing over there? Like 2
Like 290.
290?
Yeah.
You're a big sloth. That's a big sloth.
But
imagine a sloth weighing 290. You have lost weight?
Yeah.
How much were you for?
Like a little close. Almost 300.
The K5? Shit.
K5,
dude, that's a lot of fucking K5s.
Yeah.
Lost about 10 pounds in about a month, so.
A month?
That's a good pattern.
Are you on the Jenny Craig plan?
Take a shit. Yeah,
took one
lost
shit.
10 pounds.
Yeah. When always
so
taking.
Fuck you guys.
Oh. Womp womp. Are you okay?
I'm okay. Got it. My sister.
So does that mean you're going to retire the MC for Pigs Radio?
Maybe I'm undercover right now.
Ooh, undercover. Undercover.
Are you a fed?
I might be a fed.
Okay, so we have a band here tonight, and they brought forth the beatdown. He already walked through the door and challenged you. Dude, he went fucking old school, took off his fucking white glove and slapped you across the face.
Dropped the gauntlet.
Bitch. So
I'm not drunk yet, but I'm getting there. So
okay,
let's
so
get
okay.
you there. We'll get you there.
All right.
Maybe about halfway through the show.
All right. So maybe we're on the commercial break. Maybe we can have a rap battle. And we should wager something on here, though. I think it should be interesting. We'll figure it out. Maybe you have to touch your dick.
Whoever loses gets we shave their head. Oh, no, never mind. That won't work.
Mine's already partly shaved.
Shout out to Caesar Terrace.
What's up?
Oh.
Top 46
Power Shot. Whoever wins, right? It should be based on who wins.
Exactly.
Whoever wins
needs to let their hair grow out. fucking you guys up.
And the very mysterious, always giving all the hair tips for all you bitches. Let's
That's
get it
right.
for the one and only mystery nigga out the finally out the closet.
I'm letting my long and luxurious hair out of the closet at this point.
For those that don't remember, he came out on one of the shows, and now he's trying to go back in. But keep telling him it doesn't work that way.
Listen, there is no lip to tip. You know what I mean? There's none of that shit going
Allegedly.
On.
Allegedly.
I was being supportive. I put on my little fucking spandex shorts and shit.
Finger in the butt? Kanye style or what?
Pinky. the first knuckle. It was only first knuckle, okay? That's all.
By the way, so anal is a very special topic that we always cover almost every single episode. And for 201 straight episodes, I'm not going to let the public down and let any of you pigs down. But I do have a video of kind of how to approach anal and have more of a positive outcome.
That's what I'm saying.
And if I give you guys this material, would you guys maybe turn that into a song about anal?
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Gotcha.
Yeah, right?
Why not the rectum? Don't affect them.
By the way, just to let everyone know, that was not one of my new sound effects. I did not push a button. That was an actual person.
It was a button. I swear, it was a button.
All right.
And he's still pressing the button. Stop. Stop pressing the button.
I can't save it anymore. I want to give it up for the band that came back in. We have Detox in the house.
Thank you.
But not only do we have Detox, but we have the one and only, very famous and infamous, and very mysterious, more mysterious than the mystery nigga from
Super
the
mysterious.
Other side.
International mysterious.
Ooh.
Across the pond.
All the way from England.
We have English Pete. What's going on, English Pete?
Well, like I said, I came in on a lump of wood.
So we were talking about this earlier. He's more Cuban than anything else. So he just kind of came afloat and yeah.
Yes, and I speak Bitonics, Gibonics, and there's a whole list of language I talk, you know.
Do you owe taxes to the Queen? Is that why you're over here?
Yes, I'm one of those.
He's exiled.
If I was one of those, I'd be owning this place.
You are Denzel. Wait, it was that black guy, right? I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure. They all look the same
so
to me.
So is he a wolf? Is he a wolf?
Cubonics, and Britonics. That's the languages I talk.
What? What's the other one? I'm sorry?
Jubonics?
It was Jubonics.
Oh, and can I have something in Jubonics to use in a sentence, please?
Yeah, how now, brown cow?
All right, so let's go back to episode, I believe you told me 189 when you guys
were
187. Okay,
on our murder episode.
187 on the cop, undercover dick cop.
Yeah. Fed.
What has changed? Because Pete was no longer in the band. You guys kicked him out, right? Because you guys are dicks.
Yeah. And you're like, fuck Pete.
And he called in, right? And we talked to English Pete. We fell in love, and it took him, you know, months to finally get his visa and come on the show. And
his lump of wood.
And his lump of wood. Yeah. And now we have English Pete here. And now, is he playing with Detox now?
Actually, we're
so, no, that's a no. Nah, okay.
No. He's roading for
Detox.
Let
me explain.
He's carrying around Crystal's keyboards.
English Pete, are you just carrying their shit?
Roadie?
Well, no. Actually, they invited me to do some Bowie stuff. And so they give me 5 minutes with them. You know?
Yeah, 5 minutes.
5 minutes. March minute, we'll almost. Playing,
that's all I need. Yeah.
5 minutes or 5 minutes only.
Right, yeah. 5 seconds. I'm good.
All right. So starting from this way, going that way, let's get your name, the name of the band. If you have a website, spell out the website. And let's see, we already did dinosaur impressions with them, but maybe we should do something else.
Badger impressions?
Oh, badger impressions. All right. Let me have your best badger vagina impression.
Oh,
go.
Let's go.
Good Lord.
That's pretty good, dude.
That was
Yeah.
It's pretty accurate.
I think it's going to sound like that the next time she finally fucks. You know?
A new experience.
It's going to sound like a fucking suction cup.
Underdog, does
Am
that
I the judge or what?
Does that sound accurate?
That's pretty accurate.
It's like fucking Tupperware being opened up there and shit.
Those nine out of 10.
That's a 99 cent
Tupperware.
Badgerware.
Badger, if you're listening, if you agree, call in at 909-475-7449. And bitch, you already know the fucking number.
Don't act stupid.
And my name is Robbie Detox with Detox. And you can reach us at detoxband.com.
Ooh. So is that website actually new now?
Yes, it is.
It is.
Ooh.
Yeah. It's got more professional.
It still has that new smell.
The new car smell.
Okay. Hey, my dear.
This is, let me see. Can't remember my name right now. Crystal.
How drunk are you right now on a scale to one to Crystal?
So what about all that crystal?
Why are you blinking? I think she's gangster because only cholas blink that fast when you have to answer.
She's trying to signal all her girls. Hey, cuckoo, cuckoo.
Watch it. She's got a gun in her pocket.
She about to get real up in here.
Damn.
DJ Dark Crystal, part of Detox. I play synths and tech support. And Robbie already said where you could find us.
Detoxband.com.
Okay. Can you spell the band's website?
It is
www.dtoxband.com.
There we are.
There you go.
Congrats.
Pretty easy, right?
Epic. You do get life points for that, for just getting it right.
We got points. That's good.
You know, because most bands that we have on here can't spell their own band name. It's really sad.
The fucks.
That's why I went with detox. It was easy.
Just a D and a tox.
And a dash. All right. And what do you think the badger's vagina would smell? I mean, sound like?
Yeah, smell? Forget about that shit.
That's a whole different fucking topic.
It would fuck sound it. Like.
God damn, dude.
That's like some gangster queef.
That's
very queefy.
I want that on my ring.
I think I just smelled that.
That's what when she masturbates. Yeah, exactly. That's what it sounds like.
That sounded like a dead body fucking just
tumbling
thrown.
Downstairs.
Yeah,
some
dude,
shit.
That was, yeah, fuck. That was
it sounds like Chilean miners trying to get out.
That was out of order, but I love it.
So you know what? Just for that, the underdog gets fucking just...
just points.
Right, because he doesn't really say too much funny shit.
Today's that day. See what happens?
I don't know, dude. You're
he
on
He goes
it.
Away yeah. for a fucking month, and then he's got jokes when he gets back.
I know. I just started writing material, like...
You know what? I'm gonna tell you what the real truth is. It's this seat. This seat right here. We're back. You know, there was an issue at the New Pigs Radio Studio where there's no power. They're actually broadcasting episode 201 from the original podcast... place of the pigs.
Oh, right. Gee.
And the number two spot always created fucking warlords.
The
Greg, the intern rapist, when he got here.
Best moments were on that spot.
Fucking Greg.
He became like just an evil tyrant and just went crazy. Jeff, the same thing. So it's that spot. I think it's full of magical evils like that are crawling through your asshole right now.
It's like this asshole vibe and shit that's crawling up your asshole, literally.
It's like a shitload of Chilean miner just fucking crawling up in there.
I could grab his ass and get rid of it. Bend over.
English, look, you know what? I like English people. He takes initiative, see? He's like, he doesn't even have to ask. Like, I'm just,
yeah,
just
he'll
do it.
Your asshole.
I take the ass between the horn.
Just, like, me, just like any other immigrant trying to take jobs over here.
Hey. Build a wall through it's the me. Fucking Atlantic Ocean.
Where's Trump when you need him?
So tell me, English Pete, you guys have anal sex in England?
Everybody except me.
Oh, why is that?
He doesn't like it up the ass.
Thank you. Thank you for that. You're
yes, that is accurate.
Very accurate. Thank you very much. Cheers, Tom. You know, let's go. Do you want to meet later?
So I know that the English have like a phrase for everything, right? What do you call anal in England?
Spotted dick.
But we call it shagging you up the bum.
Is that a real thing? I don't know if we're fucking with me right now.
No, it's pretty real, you know. I wouldn't make this up, you know. Ask me brother over here.
Yeah, he wouldn't lie to you.
Robbie Detox. I would never lie to a mate. Am I telling the truth or not?
Oh, 100%, man.
Thank you very much.
Why'd you get scared like that? You stuttered for a minute.
He gave me that eye.
Because I'm going to evil eye. I said, if you say anything different, I'm going to kill you.
Like, oh, wow.
Get your fucking face in.
The transporter?
So how did you guys meet... a detox with English Pete, and then once again, why did you kick him out of the band?
Well, first we met in the toilet.
Okay, yeah. That makes a lot of sense.
He was trying to grab my, trying to get my cock, and I said, "Hey, this ain't George
Michael.
You're what? No freedom right here. There's no freedom here."
And I said, "You ain't George Michael.
The twin berries.
You ain't my cock."
I said, "Well, what are you doing here then?" I couldn't find it anyway.
Aww.
It's all right.
Points though.
Womp womp.
So, yeah, we met in a restroom, or in the bathroom, or the toilet, whatever you want to call it.
Bog.
Yeah, and then...
the loo.
Bogo.
The loo.
The water loo.
Bogo.
And then we're just talking about music, and next thing you know, he's in detox.
Next thing you know, he fucking, he raped me.
By the sounds of it, you can't rape the willy.
No, it's the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. For so help me God.
Then he joins Detox, and 2 years later, then we kick him out.
Long
so sorry, mate.
So
we're going more mobile. Sorry.
Yeah, there you go. Streamline Detox.
We went through that. The whole mobile thing, you know. It's like, you know. So going mobile, it's like, well, piss off and go mobile then.
How was the phone call when they finally kicked you out? Like, what happened? Like, what transpired? Or Who you came up with the decision?
Was
he,
it,
no, kick
was
him
it
out,
a text
right?
message?
He fucking texted me.
Yeah, I texted him.
You like just did just a, like a breakup text.
Yeah, like,
you're an asshole, dude.
Like, yeah,
he ditched me with a text message. Yeah. I mean, I would do that with a bird, but not with my mate. You know? Honestly, you know.
By the way, wait, what does bird mean? Are you actually texting birds? Like, what do you mean?
It's a girl.
Yeah, a girl. Birds are chicks.
A girl.
Oh, okay. Just make sure. Like, I'm trying to fucking follow
you. A bird in England is a chick.
Okay.
We need subtitles over here.
Yeah, what the fuck, dude? Where's my sap button at? Boy, I don't have a sap button for this shit.
Where's Badger at? Badger's with all the subtitles.
All right, so.
Hit the cockney button.
I think that.
Anna Branco, oh god, blimey, me ass has got a light. Appleton Pears, Dana says, oi, 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 oi.
Subtitles, please.
Hey, just subtitles.
What's that? Well, hang on, what's that, cockney button or the cocky button?
Both. So, how did you take it when you got that breakup text or you're out of the bad text? What did you text him?
I just texted him and said, you know what? We're going on a different route.
Wait, did it take 147 characters or did you go into a second?
No, I just took three. It just said, we're going a different route. That's
it. Yeah, he said a different route.
That could have meant anything to him at that point. Like, fuck, GPS, I'm going the wrong way.
I jumped up and had kittens.
I said, well, we're going another direction and, you know, it just, you know.
So what direction were you trying to go to where this guy didn't want to go to? Apparently the assholes was the two-way street.
I want to go more mobile. And, yeah.
What does that mean?
This all sounds like
it means it
you're reading directions.
Like 4G
on
LTE.
Maps
cool, they're trying to go 4G.
4G.
Is that what this means?
Yeah, we're at 2G right now, but we can go 4G.
Yeah, they're at fucking edge. They're going all the way to 4G.
Well, you have
dude.
To remember, he conned me into playing guitar and this like stuff. I'm on tour with him, even though I'm not there, you know. Right?
Yeah. Don't worry, he gets royalties.
Yeah, royalties is like sweet fuck all, you know.
I'm gonna have to everyone translate for me. It's so fucking hot.
So how did you take it? I'm sorry, I gotta finish this story. How did you take it when you got the text?
Well, I was honored that he kicked me out.
Were you really?
No.
Oh.
No, what it was is like because they changed everything to electronic. As they said, I'm probably more like classic rock. The classic rock is actually Sex Pistols, Clash, and the, you know.
Yeah, who would want to fucking copy those guys, right?
Yeah, but it's not about
Good Charlotte.
No, but I took it very lightly. I saw they went in a different direction, and I actually suggested that you might want to like do this without me. Because I'm digging what you're doing.
I think he wanted to leave in the first place.
No, it's not. No, I didn't want to leave. But I thought it sounded good what they were doing. And I think my guitar might interfere with the stuff they're doing. So I decided to, like, you know, give him a ring on the dog and bone, you know, Bob Jean, I'm finished on.
Cheers, mate. I was there all the way to the very end.
So dog and bone?
I'm sure that was the most important
the dog
part
and bone
of the whole sentence.
Lost, right?
Yeah. Fuck.
The best thing is about confusing the audience. You know? Are you with me?
I'm not, but I'm
absolutely.
Yeah, sure.
That's fucking lost. Break out the GPS.
I'm so happy you're not
away.
I'm still waiting for my text. Like, I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. I'm waiting. Everyone's getting texts.
I want to, like, make his voice on, like, replace Siri, you know?
Dude, right? That'd be the most entertaining thing.
I will.
I'll
do it for a small fee.
So, do you have other music projects going on, or...?
Yes, I'm wanking in the toilet with George Michael.
Shit. Over at Griffith Park.
Next stop, Echo Park.
Yeah, there you go.
So, after you got kicked out, then you went mobile?
Yeah, basically, I called up Crystal and I said, you know, I'm looking for a keyboard player and someone that, you know, could press good buttons and come down and
So when we had Detox at the Pigs Rio Pictastrophe a couple of years back, was
you
English
remember that
English Pete was there?
Yeah, he was there.
Okay,
I was there. I remember you, darling.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah,
I don't remember you. Well, then again, we didn't speak. If not, I would have been intrigued by your voice.
You don't remember?
He was on there, dude.
I don't remember when anything.
You were there.
Well, duh, I was there. I put the whole show on. I just don't remember. I don't remember talking to Pete
well,
at all.
There's always alcohol involved.
I had that shy moment. I think he came up and gave me the mic. He said, say something. I said, what?
He said, drop your drawers, $10.
Well, it wasn't quite like that, but, you know, I believe you.
Okay, how about this? How about this? We are going to have the Pigs Rio Pictastrophe 6. In downtown LA on May Friday the 13th. Is there any way we can get all of Detox to play one show together.
Yes.
As a reunion farewell.
That might happen.
I would say, Idi Amin.
I don't know what that means, but I'm going to take that as a yes. So, yes for Pigs Radio.
Yes.
So
see.
Yeah, that might work.
Ooh. Yeah. We just reunited. Hey, guys, guess what? We have broken up bands in the past and broken up fucking relationships.
Aww.
We just got a band back together,
that's
guys.
Good karma, man.
Yeah, right? Wow. We're doing the Lord's work. By the way, there's right, another guilty. Anal story coming up after this. But we're doing the Lord's
hey,
work.
You're going to be a cop. I think I'm going to be a priest now.
Yes. Sorry?
Really?
Yeah. As well. As well.
Drop your drawers, love.
All right, so we actually have some music with English Pete and Detox playing in one track together. Wait, no, wait, do we or don't we?
Wait, hold on. I got to call my lawyer because I got to give him some royalties. When you
okay,
play that.
Okay, so we're not going to play it with him then, but we do have a track. Now, we played this track before, but now this is the actual...
The fully mixed down.
Yeah.
Remastered.
What we had on episode 187 was straight raw, not fucking anything, but it was fucking beautiful. It was
thank
magic.
You. Right. I appreciate
it. I masturbated to that song for a whole fucking week, just to let you know.
Wow.
That was
it went
a
from
lot
an ugly duckling to a fucking beautiful
there
song.
There was a lot of knuckle babies.
Like the original Star Wars to the remastered version or what?
No. It would be the other way around, asshole. Tell him, Mario.
See, you had it. You were there, and you had a couple good ones. And then
he plateaued, dude. He just plateaued.
Shut the fuck up!
God damn it. All right, so.
Yeah, you badgered it all up.
Damn. He got coins on that one. All right, so what's this song about?
Soon and Jor?
Yes.
It's about when you don't want to see someone's face and then you just. Like,
is this about Pete?
No.
He didn't want to see Pete's face, so he texted
him. I know what it's about. Pete. You know when you're shagging a bird and she's ugly? You don't want to see her face, right?
Right.
So doggy style.
Yeah, it's about like that.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank
that's
you.
Doggy style, or you turn off
face
the lights.
On the pillow.
Now that's
it's dark.
Then when she brings you down,
that's
but you come
how
back
I feel,
up.
But I'm just
kind of like badger. You know,
it's about.
So the song's about badger.
Yeah, it's about badger.
Oh, okay, shit.
Yeah. You bring you down, but you come back up.
Badger.
Ooh.
Badger.
Badger.
Badger. Badger. Fucking whore.
I'll turn off the lights. I don't like you. You don't look good.
All right, so here we go. Detox.
Thank you.
fuck it up.
Suicide. He was loved by everyone, he was hated by himself. Wishes on the left, take his own life and his bitch. While not falling to his own eternal beat. Daniel, can you feel? Can you feel the earth's relief? Daniel can't see anymore, he can't feel his face. Religious creed amps aside, game is race. Daniel, don't you tell me why you're right, worth no sense. Ever since you left, man, the other world. Can you feel his face? Religious creed amps aside, game is race. Daniel, don't you tell me why you can't take your life anymore. Daniel can't see more, he can't feel his face. Religious creed amps aside, game is race. Daniel, don't you tell me why you can't take your life anymore.
It's called society.
Samsung Epic are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream PX Radio live anywhere in the country. So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new, cool, special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo at 562-225-8443. We welcome all new and existing customers.
Carlo's Pizza, family-owned and operated in Downey since 1964. That's a long time, folks. Carlo's Pizza, where is it? Same place it's always been, 13230 Woodruff Avenue at Foster. Not only do we have great sandwiches, we got awesome pasta specials, but besides that, let me tell you something, folks. We got the best pizza around. You want to know how I know? Because I'm Italian, and I love real, authentic Italian pizza. Where are you going to find that? I'll tell you where. Carlos. No event is too big or too small. We do catering over here. That's what I'm talking about. We cook all the food. You eat all the food. You're going to love it. Let me tell you something. We also got delivery. You're at home. You're watching the playoffs. You don't want to leave the couch. Give Carlos a call. We're going to come over there and bring you some pizza at 562-803-6753. Oof, Maron. Will Our Pizza is the best pizza in town. We got all kinds of sizes from little itty bitty all the way to a party size. It's almost 2 feet long. I don't know what I'm talking about. 2 feet long. That's a bigger pizza. You know what I'm saying? 562-803-6753. Carlo's Pizza. Or we make a pizza you can't refuse.
Hey guys, if you want to step your game up, go to LibbyGrow.com now for your free sample of the best natural sexual enhancement product available. Find out why millions of men choose LibbyGrow when they want the fun to last and last. No order to place, no club to join, just a free sample. Go to LibbyGrow.com now to get your free sample. Not because you need it, because you want it.
Hi, my name is Patty, and I survived instant death every day by listening to Pigs Radio. In case you guys don't know, we're chicks, and we love listening to Pigs Radio.
Just in case you don't know, you can't tell by our voices.
Just in case.
Yeah, I thought they were fucking men.
Hello?
I totally thought they were guys.
Did you say them? Yes, this is it.
It's English Pete.
I know we talked about getting you on Pigs Radio, but it is a little surprise you're on now. So if you don't mind saying hi to Mario and the best Jason Statham, can you just say, hey, babies, listen to Pigs Radio and Mario 81.
Listen, babies. Yeah. Listen to Pigs Radio, Mario 81.
It's real, son.
Is that Pete?
That's not Pete, goddammit.
That's not like Pete.
Not Pete.
So did we ever confirm if that was really him or not?
It is that time.
We're going off the good judgment that it was. for the show's sake.
Okay. Yeah, you're totally.
But this is what
it was
like right now. So
shh. It's Jose's favorite song.
No, it's not.
We're pigs.
Fuck, dude. You know what? I'm gonna bust the badger and just disappear. We're gonna cycle. It's gonna be ready. Diego's here this week. I'll fucking be gone fucking next week. This song. Annoys the fuck out of me.
We're pigs.
So annoying.
We're queer. So Big Radio is queer.
Is this Sum 41?
it's so fucked up, man. That's what it is.
That's actually 3FT, 3 feet, that's right. Whatever.
All right, the guys are cool. Eh? They're
yeah.
Cool. It's just
thank you guys for making that for us, even though Mr. Nigga hates it.
Yeah, it's not growing on me at all.
Pigs Radio episode 201, back in the original Pig Studios. We have an underdog. Undercover, I don't know.
Undercover dog.
Undercover dog.
Got a fed in the house.
Fuck. He's a fucking new undercover at Disneyland or whatever. Disneyland in training. Whatever the fuck.
Musketeer.
Detox here with English Pete. Now, English Pete, we were bad-mouthing you when you went to go smoke your fag and when you went to go touch yourself in the bathroom.
Yeah.
But we have a bunch of questions about.
I thought he called up like a fucking tranny or some shit. I'm going to go smoke a fag. You know,
right? That's what I thought. But then it all makes sense because Robbie went to Thailand. Lady boys,
that's right.
Sucking dick. Pete, it all made sense. It just all made sense. There's the chemistry. There it is. Boom.
I stayed in Long Beach.
Oh, shit.
At Quesara.
Because I'm more trendy than him.
That is true, though. That is true.
He's more trendy than a Bentley.
I don't know what that means. Now, okay, so we were going over. So you broke up with him on text.
Yeah, that's right.
And you did the dick move. So did you start up a new band? Say, like, you know, fuck Robbie or whatever, the Go-Getters or I don't know, whatever the fuck you want to call yourself.
No, I slept for 4 weeks.
Wow, you took it hard.
He was depressed.
Oh, yeah.
But now, but then again, he wanted to leave first, so why would he be depressed?
Because he was depressed because he was leaving me.
Yeah.
You want to be the dumper, not the dumpee or the dumped, I guess?
But when he called me to do this Bowie tribute thing, I got hard on again.
Oh, wow. That was hot. I'm not going to lie. I'm like, oh, shit.
No, tell him a lie. You know, it's the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Help my knob.
I said, Pete, I got something for you. He said, what? I said, we're going to do a Bowie tribute thing for Edward Transylvania on March 5th.
Who?
With Edward Transylvania.
I don't know that
Edward
guy.
Transylvania.
The one that looks at himself in the mirror and he actually can't see his reflection.
Give me some pain.
With the libido.
Give me some pain.
We actually had an experiment perilous play at the Pigs Radio. That was a successful night with them.
Shout out to... never mind, I can't say
never
that.
Never mind.
It's right when I say when I call him that.
Where's Badger
shout
when you
to my boy Drax.
He's out there getting some Brando bucks.
I heard about that. What's that with that Brando,
Brando Bucks?
Bucks,
that's
you'll experience it when you guys play at Spikes.
You'll find out soon enough.
It's like get drinks with Brando Bucks.
two for one vouchers for denim.
It's a 2-gene minimum.
So I gotta wear Levi's 501s dash.
Now, English Pete, do you guys have 501s in England?
Yeah, but I don't like the buttons, though.
Okay. Who does? It's fuck the buttons.
It takes a long time to get me John Thomas out, you know.
He struggles.
So, after the breakup and you went to your own projects, and how's that going for you? Is that working out better?
It's going all right. I'm playing in a band. It's like music to shag to.
All right. Fuck, that sounds better already.
Yeah. It's Barry White? Or
yeah. So, we're doing the originals and the covers, and it's anything to do with, like, shagging is involved in the music we do.
What's the name of that band you're in?
We haven't come up with a name yet, but it's...
English and the Peets?
You know, shag this, shag that, fuck this, fuck this, fucking all fuckers, fucking band. I don't want a fucking band that looks
Spotted
like that.
Pete.
No. That's a very, very long band name, by the way. I don't think that's really going to hit in the commercial world.
No, we're working on a name right now. But it's songs to shag to, anyway. That's only, I'm going to do a Bowie thing. I'm not giving away the game.
So you're stealing their idea of doing the Bowie thing?
No, he's playing
no,
with
no.
us, actually.
I'm nicking Bowie's idea. I'm not giving the game away.
Gotcha.
I'm sorry. That's me.
Go for it.
I'm holding my hand up, Mario. Mario, I'm holding my hand up. Like,
you know, this is really weird.
Hands up, you can talk.
Over here.
This is a band so fucking interesting. We all got questions.
I know. Like, okay, you go.
Okay. Can you disclose what Bowie songs you guys are doing? What was your question?
I forget now.
Ah, yeah.
So we're going to be doing Man Who Sold the World.
Oh, right on.
And we're going to be doing Ashes to Ashes.
Yeah. And we're doing like Queen Bitch as well, if you fucking like
that. That would be awesome.
Yeah, so you can imagine that. No drummer. Yeah. Because we're all mobile. You know?
Yeah, because we're tight.
So there's no drummer, but we do have the...
That's what more mobile means, no drummer.
So we got the we got the keys, and then we got the two guitars. And so this will be pretty good. And then Teresa Black... She's not black, by the way.
Oh, I'm about to say, like that's not gonna work.
She's
guys.
White as snow.
It's not gonna work.
But she's
she could be black. She could be white. We don't even know.
But she's gonna be singing vocals with us too. So it's gonna be just one pile of detoxes and just roll with
she
it.
She sounds amazing.
Yeah. So
she
we
was
just did
rehearsing
our
earlier.
We
today.
Did our first practice today, and it was amazing.
Oh, she's got spunk.
Yeah.
So this is going to be a one-time thing? Or
yeah, it's going to be a one-time
thing. Yeah, that's yeah. He's never going to talk to me ever again after that. You know.
Well, no, well, we still have the big catastrophe happening on Friday the 13th.
Yeah, so we got to do that. So
we had your commitment already. Did you already forget English, Pete?
You didn't have him sign the fucking contract soon?
Is that what I signed earlier?
Yes.
Shit.
We own you guys now.
They own their name. Fuck. They own Dean Talk.
We're going to give you a suitcase of Brando Bucks and shit on the way out.
Two for one drink special. All
right, so we actually have another track by you guys that we want to check out really quick. And hopefully between the break, maybe we can find some English Pete stuff. Can we find any of your stuff on the internet or in the interwebs or whatever you guys have in London?
How about that video?
I've got loads of stuff, but it's not over there.
Oh, okay. Well... Where we left it, maybe.
Track you're gonna play, though.
I left it in a dustbin.
And he used to play in a band called Twig and the Berries, actually.
Really?
Very popular.
Really?
I'm talking about that. When I first came to LA, just
last week.
I'm making it short and sweet.
This morning, actually.
Yeah, I came to LA this morning, you know, with a hangover. No, but I was looking at cover bands, so I decided to form a cover band for the hell of it, you know.
Right.
Because I like fish, you know.
I'm about to say, like, did he just say halibut? Like, okay,
they get you going right there?
No, but anyway, in an orderly...
It smells like, where's Badger? I don't smell halibut.
In an orderly manner, I was going into these bars, and everyone's like, sweet, I'm Alabama, buddy, oh, fucking hell, I'm fucking bored of that.
Right.
So I decided to form this band doing all British rock and roll stuff, cover tunes, you know,
right.
For the homesick Brits. It turned out that I made a mistake. The homesick Brits were all sitting in the corner getting pissed out of their heads, and the fucking K-Rock listeners from LA were fucking digging it and like jumping up and down having kittens. You know what I mean? You know?
So, what kind of band?
Wait, Mr. Nigga, can you just explain what he just said?
Yeah, he said that the fucking, they'd play like, you know, covers of English bands, but.
That's right, yeah.
he thought that the English people would appreciate it, but they didn't give a fuck about what he was doing. But the kids here, or people here, understood what they were saying. Oh, you guys high five in England? Goddamn. I didn't know
on
that.
My page.
I thought you guys fucking like punched each other or some shit. You know,
I think that's only
punch.
In rugby.
All right, well,
but I don't know why he just didn't just say that. But okay, cool.
He understands my lingo perfectly. Thank you very much.
I'm sure the underdog would too if he was paying attention. What's going on over there?
He's texting his undercover.
He's over there Snapchatting.
Will you
stop
texting that prostitute?
Like, hey, bitches.
Stop texting Badger.
Stop texting the Badger.
Hey.
She's not gonna whack you off tonight.
Oh,
no whacking off.
Sorry.
So we want to know why the Badger's not here. The second time we're on here. She's not even here. What the fuck's
up? Yeah, what's up, fucking Badger? Yeah.
Fuck, she's scared of me.
You were going to, like, motorboat my tits and all this fucking
go
amazing stimulation. Nothing fucking happened.
Yeah.
I'm here.
Fuck you, Badger. You're a bitch, dude.
Amazing stimulation.
She even wore a skirt.
What the hell?
She wore a skirt for the occasion, but.
That's right. I was ready, willing.
Yeah. You know what? I take it back. It sounds like we do have a hole in the house. So thank you.
Oh, shit.
Oh, we got points. Hey, rack them up, Brando Bucks.
Make a rate with Brando Bucks.
All right. So thank you for filling in for the Badgers. Just giant vagina.
I appreciate it.
I
mean, it's probably nothing as cavernous as Badgers, but.
Just wore the fuck out, yes, as Badgers.
Did we ever get Pete's fucking impersonation of what Badger vagina would sound like?
No. Didn't.
Pete, can we
I know you
yours?
Probably don't know this young lady, but.
Imagine from here to England, right? From LA to England.
Gotcha.
Yeah. That's how big her vagina is.
Oh, you know what? Here's an easy way to describe it. It's a chick that is stopped fucking because she just thinks she's fucked way too many people. That's how cavernous
she is. Does that mean that you dive in and you can't find your way out?
You're swimming in it. You're swimming in it, Pete.
The abyss.
The Bermuda Triangle.
It's like the Grand Canyon. Literally.
So, are you going to attempt a sound effect?
Oi, oi, oi.
All right. I couldn't imagine.
I guess that with the rolling body that was like down the stairs and.
I'm not done. All right, now I'm done.
All right, there you go.
All right, so apparently this track of Detox actually does have.
Yeah, it has Pete on there.
It has Pete, but it doesn't have Crystal.
Yeah,
it does
I'm
have
there
Crystal.
Too.
You're there too.
Yeah.
Okay,
I got them all
together.
There.
We're happy family.
Yeah, we're happy trio.
Yeah.
So how long were you guys together before you kicked them out?
5 minutes.
Text? One show.
Damn, that's some cold ass shit. That's
some
cold.
So now you're telling me that Crystal.
We're like the Beatles. We don't fuck around.
Crystal is your Yoko Ono, where you made fucking break up with Pete.
It's true, but she doesn't act like Yoko though.
She don't look like her neither.
No, she doesn't.
No, she doesn't.
No, she's nowhere near as ugly, In fact, she's beautiful,
Thank you.
Aww. No, besides that, what happened, when she came in, I cried. It's like, she just stole my job.
Oh.
And I feel fucking terrible.
Did you?
I actually feel really, really bad.
I'm glad.
Well, you mentioned
you
I'm so happy
you're a fucking
right.
asshole. You took his job.
I'm so happy you feel bad about it.
Well, you know what? In the break, she did say that she does feel that maybe you might harbor a little bit of animosity towards her because when she came in, you got booted out. You know?
She nicked my job. You know? She's
so okay.
She's a tea leaf.
You're basically like the quote unquote wetbacks and shit, fucking stealing the white people's jobs. it's like literally happening. Right here.
Did anyone else?
He's gonna vote for Donald Trump. You know that shit for sure, dude.
Did anyone else catch?
Ameki stole my job, mate.
Did anyone else catch?
I love you.
Catch that he said Yob.
Try.
He said Yob, just like a fucking beater. Just making sure that anyone else caught that.
Yob.
Okay, Yob. I heard it. All right.
I said Yob.
Yeah. Call my Yob, like a Yumbo Yak.
Yourself.
You want a Yumbo Yak?
I got a Yob.
He
stole my Yob.
All jokes aside, this is the truth. Pete is very, very, very talented.
That's the truth.
I have
other than blowjobs.
And not humble.
He has more in his pinky than I do. But
you're hotter than him. That's why you replaced him.
The story.
You know what she's saying?
Tits and vagina.
She feels
works.
So guilty about replacing me.
No.
That's why she's saying that.
I do feel guilty. I do because he's a great talent. around
you
me.
You should
and,
feel
and
guilty.
And I
know you're an asshole.
From both him and Robbie. If anything, I'm just a pupil watching, observing, absorbing. Honestly. And
you're the pubic
hair
in the
back.
You
know?
But listen, obviously Robbie saw something in you skills wise that, you know, that's why he decided
that,
for that route, that you could kind of
right.
That you're kind of canceling out what he was providing for the band.
He saw
there's something there also.
He saw the tits first, and then that's what it was.
Aesthetics aside, hey. I'm pretty sure she was capable.
See, I think if you showed your tits, English Pete, you would have had your tits.
Oh, he has. He showed his bump, too.
Let me,
shut up
that
in a
work.
Skirt.
I always
that's
show
not what it is about.
No, but let me explain this, you know. We went to bed together, but we didn't shag or anything.
Wait,
like
we gotta
that.
Play some romantic music on this.
We went through this before,
music?
You know.
What's a romantic
here we go.
Like
wait. Let him, okay, that's not romantic music. That's
no, it's,
in,
it's
in
not
America
supposed to be romantic.
It is.
It's supposed to be shallot.
Go ahead, mate. Tell the story.
Anyway, as we went through the last time I called in, I was touching his bum because I thought it was me, Roxy, my girlfriend. You know, which I love.
Bird, his bird.
I love her very much. Right. And, like, you know, I got scared when he didn't fucking stop me.
Oi,
that's a very Greg thing to say, by the way. That's a very rapey, just, you know what? Just for old time's sake, since we are in the Pigs Radio old studio.
But that's a bad thing.
Can we get a really good fuck Greg going for a minute?
Yeah, are we stopping on the floor, too, or no?
Nah, I don't want someone on the floor. You might be fucking asleep, jacking off or something. But or raping. But let's just get a really good fuck
raping.
Greg. Ready?
Fuck
Greg.
Greg.
Fuck Greg.
Greg.
Fuck Greg. Greg.
Fuck
Greg. Fuck you, Greg.
Oi, oi, oi.
All right, so we're going to check out this other track that apparently everyone's on here in Happy Family. So this happened, I'm assuming, before the first show.
Yeah, actually, this is what this
the
is
the only show.
This is what happened. I took him to the studio. I said you were gonna do some parts.
You're a dick. You fucking used him and they kick him out. You're a fucking $2 whore, Pete.
It's a bitch. I know. I know. I'm still recovering.
And why are you still here? Why are you still friends with him? You can do better, Pete. There's other assholes in the sea.
Really?
Yes.
Well, thank you for that. I didn't know that.
Now
you
yes.
I had no idea.
See, Pete, you need people like us and Pigs to, you know, let you know.
We need to point shit out.
I'm actually a little bit honored that they go on tour with me and I'm not there.
And he still gets paid.
There you go.
I am looking for a guitarist for my band.
Oh, what? The undercover band?
Yeah, do
what?
You want me to record?
Are you playing cover songs?
Hands up and watch me record on their album.
Oh, wait,
and just go and tour with it. You know?
Oh, wait. They're going to play Police songs.
Just a cast away.
Message in
a message up my party.
All right, so this next track is called Holiday or Holiday 2?
Holiday, Holiday.
Okay, because there's a 2
holiday.
On the end of this.
It's just Holiday.
Holiday, so this has nothing to do with Madonna, right?
No, it doesn't.
It was inspired by, you know, a band called The Ruts?
The Ruts?
A punk band.
The Ruts.
Oh, The Ruts, yeah.
That was my inspiration to, like, you know, throw that shit, guitar stuff out there. So I'm just letting anyone who knows a band called The Ruts, punk band from England, that's what inspired us. So lick that.
Oi, oi.
Oi.
But
we all
Pete,
say
but Pete
right
this
here.
Is why he kicked you out, because he doesn't like that shit.
No, I do. Actually, let me.
No, no.
Before you play that.
He doesn't like me.
Oh, wait.
Oh, the truth is finally out.
No,
the truth is finally out.
This is what it is. Like I always said, Pete's a great punk guitar rock and roller.
Hold on. Jose, we just got an update here live in the studio.
Yes, sir.
Detox is not like Pete because he's English. Out to you in the, out to you in the field.
Mario, I'm sitting across from Pete, and I'm looking at him like, I can see the disdain in the band's face. They do not like him.
It's so funny because
you're an immigrant.
Yeah, but I assimilated, though.
Get your green card, mate. Get your green card, and we'll start talking.
It's not green. It's
pink. Another foreigner taking jobs from Detox.
But you guys are all Mexicans,
at
right?
At least he don't sell oranges.
Well,
I'm Juban.
All right, so let's hear your pathetic story before you play this song.
So here he goes. He is a really great guitar player, and he puts a lot
sad
of
music.
He put a lot of influence in the band, and as far as will we like to keep him, yes, but the music has changed in a different way.
And I'm an asshole.
It's evolved.
It's evolved, like you just said. You know?
And Pete just didn't evolve with you guys.
Yeah, it's just, you know.
Damn. He hired a guy.
Making light of it.
He hired this geezer called Roland.
Right.
And we just didn't get along.
So,
what if he always shows up on time? That's why.
Oh, damn. Snaps, sick bird.
What if you would play the keytar?
Snaps,
oh. The
what?
The keytar.
The keytar. Then it'll take the keytar. It'll take your job.
Think of that. Okay, no. You can steal your job back if you learn to play the keytar.
Yeah. Yes, that's why they call
and show your tits.
Yeah. Like General Motors and shit. Now wear a skirt, but you're not in, you're not Scottish,
did
so
you know?
Can't wear a kilt, you know what I mean?
Put a wig on.
He does have some flannel going on his jacket, though, so.
Just tie it around your waist. Just tie it around. Turn it inside out.
Have you ever read what I got on my T-shirt?
No.
You got to read it to the audience.
Oh, shit.
I don't think he could read right now.
I really can't. You're asking me for the impossible right now.
Okay, put your glasses on.
Boy, that's like a whole essay right there.
We're gonna text a picture of that and put it up on the pig site. Oh, wait.
Religions of the world. Taoism. Shit happens. Hinduism. This shit happened before. Mormon. Shit happens again and again and again. Buddhism. When shit happens, is it really shit? Seven Day Adventist, shit happens on Saturday. Protestantism, shit won't happen if I work harder. Catholicism, if shit happens, I deserve it. Jehovah's Witness, knock knock, shit happens. Judaism, why does shit always happen to me? Hare Krishna, shit happens, Rama Rama Ding Dong. Atheism, no shit.
Exactly.
TV evangelism. Send more shit. Rastafarianism. Let's smoke this shit.
Yeah. You expect me to read all that shit? Fuck.
That's a lot of shit.
Fuck that shit.
Dude, be on the second.
Whoever put that on a shirt is awesome, but at the same time, stupid. Ain't no one gonna fucking say, hey, excuse me, sir, can I read your whole fucking shirt?
Yeah.
It's a fucking essay on your goddamn shirt.
That's full of shit.
Fucking
right
English,
there.
Pete. You know what?
That's bullshit.
Got English, overdoing it and fucking overthinking
shit.
I was just seeking attention.
Obviously, Pete, because you don't belong to a band anymore because it kicked you out because you're an asshole. But they're assholes too via fucking text. And he's mad because you don't show your fucking tits and wear a fucking skirt. God damn.
See, that's all I wanted.
You know what? You know what? You tell me your fucking story after we hear Holiday. How about that? Here's Holiday by Detox on fucking Pigs Radio with English Pete. We'll be right back.
got a new 4G phone. The Sprint HTC Evo and the Sprint Samsung Epic Arcade both have flash players, so you can stream PX Radio live anywhere in the country. So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new cool special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo at 562-225-8443. We welcome all new and existing customers.
I like we're not even back from the like commercials break and we're getting phone calls.
Is there Arturo calling us?
I don't know, but caller, you're on pigs.
Hello?
Caller.
Hello.
Hello, caller.
You want to talk some shit?
Yeah.
Caller, fuck you.
Eat a dick, nigga. Eat a dick sandwich, homie.
I just got a text from my mate. He said you don't need a guitar when you have a pitar.
That wasn't on mic, P. You should have said that shit on mic.
Hey, Larry, let's try this again. Caller,
you should put that on a t-shirt.
Hold on. Caller, you're on pigs.
Simpler.
Let's market that. Hi, how's it going?
It's going.
So.
What's going on?
Hi, caller.
Who are you?
I was told to call this number that y'all are like, giving away free pizza or something.
I think I recognize that voice.
Who is this, English
free
pizza?
Are you doing the David Bowie stuff?
David Bowie pizza. What's that? Someone told me to call this number to get free pizza.
Is that Ty?
Ty.
Hey, it's Ty.
Hi, Ty. Yep.
Oh, that's Teresa Black, but she's really not black.
Yeah.
Oh, the non-real black person. God.
Man,
Teresa White.
Stop using my government name. My name is Ty.
Like Ty
for slave name.
Yes.
Don't be using my government name all on the internet.
Government cheese.
So, how do you know the band?
Well, truth be told, that I was once myself a naked civil servant.
Hey.
But I wasn't really. Well, I was kind of a naked civil servant, but I wasn't really a naked civil servant because I never got naked.
Uh-oh.
And I was never civil.
Right.
And I ain't a servant to anybody.
That's right.
You ain't no slave.
Fuck them people.
You didn't have the balls to take your clothes off like we did, right?
Take your trousers down.
Exactly. I didn't have the balls to take my clothes off because I don't have balls. But
even
anyway,
I've got the biggest balls of all.
That's a good thing.
I need a Thai translator.
I used to sing. Actually, I sang with Robbie some, and then I got kicked out of the band, although I was never really a member
of
the band.
See, another one bites the dust.
So
another one bites the dust.
I love how
it's kind of an epidemic.
It's kind of
an epidemic with detox.
Did you get a text message saying you weren't in the band anymore?
Did you get broken up by Robbie through text?
No, but he broke the news the same way as you did, I think.
No, he called me. Look.
Not you. I'm not talking to you. Right.
Wow. So you actually called this person in your band that wasn't really a member, but kind of a member, and you fucking called her and kicked her out.
She wasn't really a member.
And I was a member.
She was a member, but not really a member. She was like a side member.
No, but
you know what I mean? Like,
so
you
choose her side piece.
Exactly.
You're the
side
piece.
Yeah, you are special because when he fired me, he didn't even call me. It was a text message.
So you get flowers on February 15th?
Right. I want flowers for Valentine's Day.
Want chocolates too?
Yeah. Of course.
So how did it make you feel when Robbie kicked you out of the non-band you were a part of?
The pretend band.
Actually, was kind of liberating.
Oh wow! So I've had enough of this asshole.
Like you just took off your bra, right?
Well, actually, I went home and I
and
got
grew some balls. Sorry, carry on.
Don't mind English Pete, he's an asshole.
Yes, I am.
Still there?
Are you with us?
No, you're good.
He's a cunt. You fucking cunt.
That was really dramatic, like, yes,
you know
yes, he is.
Coming from you, I'll take it as a compliment.
So, and Is there any way, since Pigs is here reuniting Detox, apparently for their final farewell tour together as a group, they're going to branch off and do the mobile thing and push buttons? Can we?
Dude, we can't get back together because we...
Because... Oh, wait, I didn't hang up on her. Yeah. Are you still there?
Was she censored?
No, I'm still here. My phone goes...
All right, yeah, say that again because you're
out of the tunnel.
Cut off, Ty.
Oh, no. What I was saying was, is like...
God.
Bleep, bleep, bleep.
We were never all together to begin with.
No. Well, I know, but I'm trying to create the Detox super group. Trying to get the band back together.
No. It would be like the Detox...
The Detox reunion. And all in one breath.
It's a Detox reunion.
You know, it would be like a Detox flunky crew and shit because it's everybody that got bounced out.
Can I explain something? We're going to be like the Rolling Stones.
It's just one of those ones, you know,
it's
like we're all just happen to be hanging on to the same street corner at the same time. And
that's right.
So you do wop around.
I'm a prostitute as well.
By the way, there's always that one band member that just won't agree because they're just so upset about shit.
Now, what I was going to say in an orderly manner is we're going to be like the Rolling Stones. We're going to argue, fight, kick each other's head in, and in 30 years' time, we're going to have a reunion tour when we're wrinkled.
And they're going to sue the fuck out of me.
Pete, you'll be dead by then. Yeah. We don't have that kind of time.
No.
We're not
I know Keith Richards' drug dealer.
So what say you that we can't say your government name on the internet radios? Can we get you to join in them for one song at the Pigs Radio Pigtastrophe?
Will you?
You know, she's actually playing with us on March 5th.
He said, will you lick his love pump?
I don't know what that is, but I'm asking, would you perform?
I don't know what that is either. But I don't think I want to lick it.
Okay, yeah, don't.
Don't worry. You need a long tongue for that one.
Okay, so I'm sorry.
You have experience.
But what I am asking is that if you will come down for one day and play with all the ex members, which is pretty much everyone like in this room but Robbie.
It's like the Detox B Squad or C Squad.
The original guy.
Detox X's.
Can we get you to play with everyone on stage all together one time?
Sure. I'm down for that.
There we go. So there confirmed on live radio, Pigs Radio is having all of the Detox and the X's performing live at Mal's.
Fuck, this happened.
Detox D Squad.
X's, side chicks.
Side bitches.
Side bitches. Side pieces.
Side piece.
Well, ain't no bitch. That's a side chick. Get
baby
it right.
Mamas.
All right. Well, we're excited to announce that we're going to have all of what was once Detox at one point in time and then became another Detox. And Robbie, why do you keep kicking everyone out? Why do you hate everyone so much?
You know what? You should kick yourself out, dude.
He's a cunt.
I tried, but I always get myself back.
Hey, look at that. He's going to kick you out.
I think Crystal's going to kick me out.
Did you know?
I think Crystal's going to take over.
He's going to kick himself out one day.
Yeah,
kick myself in the head.
Hey, but Ty's going to sing with us for the
David Bowie.
Yeah, she's doing the Bowie tribute thing.
Oh, okay.
You know?
Tribute.
Oh, so you'll have both the...
You still with us,
yeah.
Ty.
Okay.
See, the thing is about, you know, with the ex-band members, they're still family to me. So every time, you know... I want to do something special. I call them in. Yeah. And they come back,
How special are they? Are they special where you just invite them down to come and play?
No, what
or do you invite them down and then you break off some Brando Bucks?
He's like Donald Trump.
We can break off Brando Bucks. I'll break off some Donald Trump.
In fact, it's Robbie Trump.
I'm Robbie Trump.
He's got a new name. It's like...
I wish I had his money.
Robbie Trump and the wanker, you know? But no, what he does is like he fires you. What are you laughing at?
No, but what I'm saying is that
the
thing is about Detox is that it's just evolving from what it was to now. And it's
so
just
how many months or years before you kick out Crystal?
I know, really. I'm counting.
You know what? You know what, Crystal? You got the tits. You just take this shit and run with it.
No. But let me tell you.
She has vagina, too.
Robbie does not fire tits.
That's where
I don't fire tits.
That's where the power's at. You know,
that's
the
why
tits,
they live in
the
Nipply Ever After.
But listen, obviously, you know, this... We can't say her name.
Ty.
Okay. Ty and Mother Dan.
So Ty had tits and vagina too, right? But you still kicked her out.
I didn't kick her out. I never did.
No, you called her.
I was never a member.
She was never a member.
She was never a member.
She was just affiliated.
She was affiliated.
She was your artist.
Listen, it's the Keith Moon syndrome.
She was.
She said, I was sitting in the band for the last 30 years.
There you go. I called her in for a couple of songs. You know, we actually did a really cool Iggy Pop song.
Is that available on the tube?
I really it might be. We did the Iggy Pop song that we did.
Candy.
And she came up and we did this whole spill on fucking K-Sara. It was so great.
It was great. And you done a great job, by the way.
And we've always done that. We're always tag team like that. Like, she'll come up and she'll play some song with us, and she really wanted to do the boat. She actually hit me up about the boat.
So you guys like orgied each other musically.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, she introduced one day she showed up with a wireless mic. And then when she went home and had a cup of tea, he's running around. And can I borrow that mic? He's running around like unbelievable. Because Ty's like running around going to the audience with his
wireless mic.
Yeah,
for a minute, I thought I was having a stroke. Like, is English Pete okay?
I was having a stroke. Yeah, I'm having a fit.
I got scared for a minute.
Hey, can I explain something?
Yeah, we
don't have a tea withdrawal symptom over here, right? Just to explain that. But anyway, after she introduced the wireless mic, he had a fit and fucking running around all over the shop, you know, with the wireless mic, and he lost it as well, by the way.
What did I lose?
Her mic. Mystery nigga, can you translate?
Can you put a cockney on that, please?
Oh, no.
I can understand what he was saying. I was lost.
Did you know I have an amplifier that has different accents? I press this button. What are you doing? And I press this button. I said, fuck off, you Indian cunt. And that was it. I'm Greek. No, I'm serious. What are you laughing at? I'm being serious. I've got effects pedals that fucking mimic me. And they're making a different, accents all over the world.
Hey, all right, English Pete, I need to know something. So you're the best person who can answer this. Why is it when English people sing, their accent go away? What the fuck?
It's because we love America.
Because what?
We love America.
I don't know.
Press the cockney button.
I don't even know America, dude.
I said I love America. I
said he loves America.
I'm talking about all the other fucking English. They all, I highly doubt.
Oh yeah, no, I know, but
even the Scottish
audience.
People do that.
Yeah, but it's
appeal to American
audience. Even the Scottish people do
Pete,
that.
Oi Pete, show me your American accent.
Yeah, but it's like fucking. What is it, Green Day? All of a sudden, the fucking guy sounds fucking English and shit when he's fucking singing.
I want to hear your American accent.
Do you want to hear my American accent, love?
Yeah, let's hear your American accent.
Damn motherfucker.
Fucker. Trying to roll his R.
That's as far as it goes, you know.
Is that South accent?
I think it's Southern, yeah.
I think I got it from Ty.
It's all right. Just say he's from Milton Keynes.
Well, the Southern accent don't go away.
Oh, yeah, she's from the South, actually.
Did you like my accent?
Well, nice greens.
I'll tell you right now, it's pretty obvious. I thought she was lynching fucking black people in her fucking backyard and shit right now.
She did. No, one thing with Teresa, she said she went with her grandfather one day. And lynched loads of black people. And I said, why would you do that? She said, because they mugged my fucking granddad, so I'm going to fucking take care of business. We're not going to court or anything.
My grandpa boyfriend.
She loves collard greens.
She likes
mac and cheese.
Pete, you're about to get stabbed
barbecue.
In real life.
I think I'm going to have to go back to England now.
They're gonna deport your ass.
By the way, this is the scariest white girl I've ever heard.
Oh, you should see her in person.
I'm really scared. I'm really scared. I invited her now.
We were gonna have her come down.
She's gonna let you in.
She's gonna, you know what she's gonna do? She's gonna come over and kick in the teeth.
Yeah. And she's gonna say you're gonna like it.
She don't have any teeth herself, by the way. She's just jealous.
Why don't you have teeth? Are you on meth?
Yeah, they're all fat. That actually, fell out.
Don't you know teeth are optional in Georgia?
Oh. That's truth right
BJ.
There.
Oh, you got some bucks.
They make better for BJs.
Oh, yeah. Hello.
What's your cover heard that?
By the way, that came from our
now you have my attention.
You know, you're the 100th caller. You get a prize. I don't know what it is, though.
I'll be there.
There's your prize right here.
We got your prize sitting right here.
So thank you for being our resident whore today.
Hey. Yep.
Who's the resident whore today? I thought Pete was.
Resident whore.
Well, actually, they're all filling the horseshoes today.
Yes. Teresa, you're not a whore. I am. You are a whore, but I'm a bigger whore than you are. So, just to let you know.
Hey, Teresa, just on the record, I never fired you.
Yeah,
but you're always welcome to sing with us.
It's still a cunt.
You fired her on a phone call. She just said that.
I never fired her.
She just acknowledged that.
She was never in the band. How can I fire someone?
So what was
it? Never in the band.
So what was the phone call about?
She was like the you picked her up. Where at the Home Depot and shit in fucking Georgia.
Like, hey, you sing.
I picked her up at the cotton field. I picked her up at the cotton field on the horse. I said, hey, want to sing some detox?
Oh, my God.
She was in the
Do you just hang out at Guitar Center, like, picking up artists or what?
Yeah, hey, you.
Hey,
you sing?
You're a good bass player. Get over here.
I'm never in the band either. He said, when you learn these songs, try out. I was sitting in like Keith Moon did with The Who, you know. Never a band member. You know?
Wait, what the fuck?
I'm not a band.
Will you translate? Will you translate?
You're on the flyer. Wait, you're on the flyer, and so is Pete. Look.
And then some other guy that fucking doesn't want to be fucking caught on film, obviously.
All right, my dear. Well, thank you for calling the show. We'll see you on the 13th. Please don't kill anyone when you show up.
don't leave your rope at home.
She's
going to be playing with us on March 5th at the tribute for David Bowie. She's going to be singing some songs with us.
That's going to be held where exactly?
At Spikes. Rosemead.
Spikes and Rosemead by Edward Trancel Sexual.
Trancel Sexual.
And they will be paid in Brando Bucks and denim.
It's probably going to be a lot of denim there.
It's going to be a lot of denim.
And she sounds beautiful.
Guys and lady, y'all have a wonderful evening.
Thank you. We love you, Teresa.
You too, love.
Love you too. Take care, sweetie.
The South will rise. Wake up, white people.
Yeah. Drop your drawers and 10 bob drawers.
The whitest black girl you ever met.
She's pretty gangster and pretty white.
She is.
She's what?
She's
Cockney
cool
butt.
No, I can't hear your mic. You gotta talk into the mic.
You have to translate. Sound is a pound.
Oh, yeah. What is that?
I'm sorry. Say again? You kind of caught me off guard.
It means she's just slag.
I don't know what that is. Well,
I don't know what that is. That means she's all right.
She's all right. Yeah.
Totally.
No, it's
not
a
world, though, because today when I walked into rehearsal, she was there singing.
And she's like, oh, I got replaced.
Like, damn, let's go.
She's like, you know how birds get? It's like, there's another bird here singing.
She took off her earrings and put up her hair in a bun, and she's like, well, I'm going to start boxing.
Got the hoop earrings and shit. Or bamboo earrings.
Yeah.
Cat scratch fever.
Took off her heels.
She
she's
like, hey,
he's like, what the fuck are you doing here, you slag?
Yeah, I was like, hey. And then I was like, oh, Ralphie. She's a Ralphie because.
But the only reason why you survived, I will survive, is because you sing and play keyboards. So, you know.
And have tits.
And have tits.
And a vagina.
I didn't notice the knockers, to be honest, you know.
The knockers. Because
my fucking girlfriend would kick my head in if I said, oh. There's a naughty bit of a pair of knockers over there. You know?
A naughty bit.
I mean, I would have no Willy. No, John Thomas, gone.
Cut off his dick.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you.
I'm like looking at me for a second.
I'm so happy I got a translator.
Yeah.
You're
better than a transsexual, right?
I'm done with plenty of English people.
You know, but he didn't want to come out the closet, right?
What we should have did was call Andy What You Wanted, because Andy What You Wanted is a man of mystery.
Oh, yeah.
Who has been out to England.
Yes,
and
he has.
I forgot. I switched that out for fucking Greg, so that's the Dave Ray song, not the Andy song.
Fucking up.
But the wonderful wilderness that is Andy has traveled all over the world to see many sights and sounds that have to do with Harry Potter and Doctor Who.
Right.
And Lady
Harry
Gaga
Potter.
And
Harry
a bunch
Potter.
Of other
Katy Perry. He's an international type of guy.
He is. He's probably asleep right now, but he is. He's a magical man of mystery.
He's a sleep bad fuck.
Hands up, who knows how long Doctor Who has been going on for? How many years?
25 years.
30 plus?
No, you're right off. It's 40 or 50 years. But if you listen to the original signature tune for it, they were BBC, which is like they rock.
Right.
If you listen to all the synthesizers back then, back in like the 1960s, this was way ahead of anything that Human League ever did, you know. Listen to the original soundtrack of Doctor Who 40 years ago, and I fucking, it'll blow your brains away. It was so advanced, you know. And everyone's looking at me like, so what?
No, no, no. Well, I mean, it was all done on Moogle.
I was like, fuck. Like, I have homework. I have to go listen to it now. Like, goddamn.
Okay, I took it the wrong way then.
Yeah.
Stanley Kubrick, or the audio?
The synthesizer.
Yeah. Bradley Cooper?
Let me tell you about the BBC. The reason why we had Monty Python and everyone showing their dicks and asses is because we didn't have Pepsi Cola and Budweiser dictating that shit, you know? I mean.
Oh. I'm lost.
BBC, the British Broadcasting Company. The reason he's saying that they don't need commercials because it's paid by the government.
So
the broadcasting there is a government run thing.
And it's not a PBR here that they have to have everyone like call in for 5 years and all that. But the BBC had no one to like no one to tell them what to do. You know.
Yeah.
So that's why you had like Monty Python and the Young Ones and all that great stuff.
Yeah.
And they all went like this to everybody, but no one could complain because they weren't sponsored by fucking like corporate companies and all that shit, you know. So
right, they can't boycott the product.
They can't.
That sponsors that show.
They couldn't
because
touch
it's
it.
The
they
product
couldn't
is
it.
The
so
country.
They did what they liked. Right. You know, that's what I really loved about that. You know, they just did what they liked. Just like this radio show. If you're on the BBC, you'd probably be doing the same thing there.
You know what, guys? That's the goal now. We need to be on BBC.
That's
BBC?
Right.
Big busty cunts.
Right. I like that terminology.
Yeah, BBC stands for something else.
You already have that. It's called Badger.
Well, yeah, but yeah.
Badger's busty cunt.
Yeah. She is a cunt. You know why? Because she's not here. So
that's
We're going to drill her like a fucking... like a 40-inch dildo.
You look like you're smoking that fucking microphone.
I might.
Like Badger's cunt. That dick. Oh, see, I got that. I can point for that.
Fuck you, Badger. You didn't come here.
Yeah, fuck you, Badger.
Fucking bitch.
She didn't fucking call in.
What the fuck?
You didn't even call in? Bitch. Call in no show? What the fuck's that about?
Fucking
no
bitch.
No call, no show, no pussy.
You're
no
fired.
Yeah.
Thought you were the real
fuck
deal.
Badger.
I think she got scared of us. That's what it was.
I think so.
Yeah.
She's like, detox coming. We're going to get fired. I'm not going to come in today.
I'm scared. I'm getting
right undercover.
No,
she's
but he hired me to. But check this out.
Some jack off going.
I'm doing this tribute thing for Bowie. I'm scared I'm going to get fired before we get to the gig.
Oi, you got to find a ride home.
I get that text. Yeah, I got you that Uber, son.
There you go.
Can I get a lift?
Wait, what happened?
Badger drives Uber.
I heard. Have her come pick up. Have her come pick somebody up.
We're doing so good. And then, yeah.
You went from A to fucking Z in a minute.
Oh, totally.
A to
from
Manny.
100 to 0 real quick.
Yeah. 2.51 seconds.
All right. On that sad note, thank you guys for coming down, hanging out with the fucking pigs.
Yeah.
You guys are playing again, doing some Bowie stuff at Happening at Spikes and Rose.
We're also
Street.
Playing the anniversary for Guy 80s on February
13th.
So come check that. You know,
can I just say the last word? I'm also playing with myself when I go home tonight.
And then not to mention, for the first time ever, the universe is going to implode on itself. We're going to have all members and non-fictional members of what was Detox.
Pseudo-members of Detox.
The side bitches of fucking...
Right. Side piece.
Side piece
let's
of Detox.
Let's be polite here, side piece.
We're also doing the Goth Festival that's going to be happening in Westminster. And that's going to be February 19th.
Wait, there's a goth festival happening in Westminster.
Yeah.
Isn't there nothing but Asians there?
It's gonna be
a little Saigon?
Saigon.
Did you know
Thailand?
Robbie, he looked at his history, and he realized his real name is Kunta Kante.
Oh, where's Teresa? I better run. No, my real name is Robbie. No, it's Kunta Kante. No, it's Robbie.
Make your mind up.
Yeah, you're doing the... Goth Fest.
That's right.
Goth Fest in Westminster.
It's going to have headlining Two Witches.
Two Witches.
Hell yeah.
The Gorgonas.
Yeah, I don't know who that is.
The Gorgonas.
Shadow Image.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
And really
Detox.
And then, Detox, I know.
We'll also be in Mexico City February 20th the next day, so we fly out like that morning.
Dang, so you guys are like
fucking
crazy as rock stars.
What was the date on that again?
February 20th.
I want to come have some tacos with you.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some tacos.
So is English Pete invited to go to Mexico?
Sure.
Yeah, yeah, dude. Somebody's got to carry the synthesizers.
As a group, I'm invited as a fucking groupie.
Fucking assholes. Fucking detox.
Fucking cunts, you know.
But you know, it's always a pleasure to be on Iron Pigs Radio.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, thank you for
always,
coming down
always.
And bringing out all the...
Ex-members.
Past members, future past members.
All the residual, all the residual stuff, you know. I was very honored to be here. Thank you for the invite.
English Pete, thank you for coming down on your board, hanging out. Dude. Let us know what I didn't understand a goddamn thing you fucking
yeah,
said.
I got to practice my fucking English.
Thank you for translating being
English
myself,
to but English.
But it's pretty obvious.
You're better than Google right now.
But I told you we were going to bring
you
it down.
How much
are
you paying for
you.
Translating anyway, you know?
Oh, we pay him a shitty beer.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Fucking beer. I've had six of them. I'm not even buzzed.
Shit,
like, fuck, dude.
I'll translate for myself.
Me means I, okay? Just in case.
I?
Yeah, me, like, myself, and I.
All right, on that note, go check out fucking Detox. Check out their website, thedetoxband.com.
Oh, see how easy that was?
Yeah.
That was easy, just like Badger.
Boy.
Easy.
Well, apparently not anymore.
Watch out for the underdog poser. Being an undercover dick in Disneyland.
He's going to practice pulling people over right now. Yeah. He's like,
pull over.
You write on tickets.
He'll probably go destroy the badger's vagina after this episode.
Are you going to be doing the whistle with the conducting traffic and all that stuff? All
right, well, let me ask this before we sign off here. Are you going to be here? Do you get the babies? Do you get the Pigs Radio babies next weekend, or is it going to be better?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Damn.
Daddy, are you going to pick me up today?
Well, no, I'm be in Vegas next weekend.
I'm pregnant.
Oh, yeah, so Badger will be here for sure.
I'm pregnant.
Man, is that true that Badger has a VIP parking spot at Planned Parenthood?
No, she has
a platinum member.
She has a punch card that gives you rewards points. So the last time she let me know is that her next abortion is free. So
did you know I've got this thing patented?
What thing?
You know you've got the magnetic strip on your card. I don't go to strip clubs personally. Roxy, I hope you're not listening to this.
That's his bird, by the way.
But
that's
what you
his
do
number.
Is like, in the, you know, this is new technology. You put the strip under the stripper's ass, right? And then you slide your card, you know, and you cop a feel. You got me? So you slide
the card up her ass,
up her ass,
and then she gets paid.
It's like a square reader in their asshole.
There you go.
You know,
see, he learned. He's quick.
Up. That's right. Yeah. So you slide the card up there,
up the bum,
and you cop the feel already. Probably like $20-$30. But I'm working on this technology myself, you know, and I don't even go to strip clubs, to be honest.
Male or female?
Both.
Okay, just make sure. I like to know that English Pete is an equal opportunist.
Oh, yes.
Well, he is from England.
Money,
that's yes, I'm not racist.
On that note, pigs out.
Fuck Badger.
Fuck Badger.
Fuck Badger.
DJ, stop the music. Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Initiating shutdown sequence. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
This show may cause birth defects and or cancer. Void where prohibited in the Southern Red States. Official sponsor of the Special Olympics. Not really. 2% financing available for nothing. See your official Toyota dealer for recall as penalty for not buying American. This show may cause massive amounts of marijuana consumption. This show has been a joint venture of cockballs and ass. Free salad tossing available. Upon request, visit RobertReese.com. Sexual relations among cousins is not incest.